30% increase. I always wanted a thing called tuna sashimi. 3, 2, 1.
Back again. Basically, this time I'm going to review Otomedius Gorgeous or Otomedius G, doesn't matter how you want to put it. Basically, first I'll start off saying I love the Gradius games. Pretty much, they're all fantastic. The last Gradius game that Konami made was Gradius 4, but then they subbed it out to Treasure to do Gradius 5, which is fantastic. But then they also made like a comic sort of remake of the Gradius games, like a parody of it called Parodius, which are also amazing games. Parodius are really good fun, they're just as good as the Gradius games. And then that was it, they didn't make any Gradius games for quite a while. And then Konami came back in the arcades then, and then they made Otomedius. Maybe get that name right. And basically Otomedius is another parody on the Gradius games, so this time it's with anime girls and big boobies. So that came out in the arcades and it was touchscreen. It was free levels. You played free levels on various difficulties to unlock things, and you had some like card system or something you could put in and it keep your scores and your points and stuff like that. And then it got released on the 360, which is what this version is by you. The menus are all in Japanese, so not very Western friendly. There's two versions of the game on you. You've got the original Otomedius arcade game with its free level structure, which is by here, and then by here then you've got Otomedius Gorgeous, which is the 360 version, and it's got 6 levels. It's got some levels from the first game, slight changes here and there. Like in Otomedius you start off with a shield and you can't actually get a shield and you've got 2 smart bombs, but in Otomedius Gorgeous you don't start off with a shield, but you can pick a shield up if you're going through your Gradius power-ups and so on. You got smart bombs as well. So we'll start with the arcade version. Lots of, so we'll go back. So you got these menus which give you like the characters and like an illustration of the characters and different various things characters do, which is pretty cool. Got a nice lot of artwork, which is cool. I love the artwork anyway, it's brilliant. But you got that. This option here allows you to mess around with the weapons. As you play through the game, you get more points and you get these like extra weapons, so you can mess around with the actual weapons of the game and the weapon sets. But you won't mess with that because it just gets all confusing in Japanese. But what I'll say is, when I first played the Otomedius games, especially the second game, I wasn't sure whether I liked them, and I gotta be honest, I didn't really like them at first. And I do think that this first version is better than the second one. And what I say is, I didn't like it that much as first either, but the more I play this game, the more I'm starting to like it. It sort of grows on you a bit. It's by no means a fantastic game, mine, but it's not as good as the Gradius games, all the Parodius games, but it does start to grow new. So we'll have a go with the arcade version first, and then we'll have a go with the actual Otomedius Gorgeous game then, the 360 version. I say the arcade was touchscreen. Apparently this came out in Japan with touchscreen controls. It had like a special controller with a joystick with a touchscreen thing on it. I think I've only ever seen that in pictures. But you don't need it, you can go for the menus. So I'm not going to mess around with the ships. I'm just going to start it up. We'll see how far we can get. Maybe I'll go for the free levels of a bit of luck. If not, I don't, and then we'll start the other one. So we'll I'll cut the chat off now, and we'll go into the game. And
single mission.
This is the first mid boss. He's not too bad, especially with this weapon. This weapon's pretty powerful, so he's reasonably easy with this weapon. I say the original arcade mode is in 4.3, as you can see. I got it then. 4.3. The arcade mode does, it drops coins and things like that, but you haven't got that on the gorgeous mode. But I say both modes are pretty good. The widescreen mode does look reasonably quite nice as well, but I think on reflection I think I'd like to look at the 4.3 mode a little bit nicer. But I say I'll carry back on with the playing, and then we'll
ミッションに向かってください。
Thank you.
Right then guys, that's a playthrough of the original Otomedius arcade on this disc. I say the original one is in three levels. You got to pick a set of three levels, your difficulty, you go way through until you unlock. So I unlock something for my ship then. Got to level up. That's cool. I think you just play through it multiple times. But like I say, I didn't like that at first, but I have no idea what I'm doing now. But yeah, but so the more I play this game, the more I quite like it. So what we do, we'll cancel back now. And then we'll have a go with the gorgeous mode. Right, okay, so now we'll have a go with the gorgeous mode, which is the 360 console version, which are 6 levels now instead of 3. So we've got 3 new levels. They've redone the graphics in this. There's lots of other options, like, you know, customizing your ships and stuff. This version apparently is free player as well. You can play 2 players on your console, or you can play 1 player online or 2 players online, you and your console. But we're not going to be doing that. We'll just have a go with the playing single player. As you can see, he's got the same sort of ships. I like the artwork in this game. The artwork's pretty nice. So we'll use the same girl and the same ship. I will have manual. Like I say, this version, you know, there's your extra power-ups as well, so you have unlocked a few bits and bobs, but I'll leave them as they are, I think. But like I say, this is a nicely done in widescreen. This is more like a game. The arcade version is more like a quick go thing. 3 levels seems very, very short for a game. But the third level on this, if I can get that far, the third level is like a sort of remake of the first level, the first gradius level, and it's pretty cool. See if you can hear tapping this, my arcade stick. I always like to play shmups on an arcade stick if I can. Yeah, and here we go. Into a remake of the arcade level now. So the level setup is different on this as well. So what I'll do, I'll cancel commentary off in a second, so and then we'll see how far.
Into the head. けちゃったのね。
ミッションコンプリート。今回は完璧でした。次のミッションに向かってください。 築き上げし文明の力思い知るがいいわデストロイザコア来たれブルースネーク
Well then guys, that was a bit of a rubbish go on that level, wasn't it? Oh well, there you go. Anyway guys, that's Otomus Excellent. There is another level after this. This is the 360 version. There's a bit of an upgrade on the arcade. As you can see, the game looks a bit more 3D than it did before. The more I play this game, the more I like it. It's definitely not as good as the normal Gradius games. It's not as good as the Parodius games. But, I'm starting to, quite enjoy it again. Coming back and find myself playing it more and more. It's a pretty nice package. You can pick this package up for about... I paid $20 for a second hand. And that was about a week or two ago, something like that. And you can buy it... I've seen it for £30 brand new. I've also seen it for about 26 brand new, but then that's postage from China. But that was a UK company, Genki Games, have got it for 30, which is pretty cool. Not bad game. If you like Gradius games and you've got a Japanese Xbox, because that's all you need to play these games, it won't work on a UK one. If you've got the ability to play these games, why not pick them up? May as well. They're pretty cool, but if I was going to review it, I would say it's a good shoot 'em up but not a fantastic one, so I'd give it 7 out of 10, which is pretty average result. It's pretty good, like you might find you enjoy a bit more now, but give it a go. But anyway guys, that's Otomus Excellent, well Otomus Gorgeous, keep getting confused between the two games, and I'll catch you again in the next review.